स्टॉक मार्केट रेगुलेटर सेबी चेयरपर्सन मदाबी पुरी बोज सीम्स टू बी इन ट्रबल फ्रॉम टॉक्सिक वर्क कल्चर टू जीज सुभाष चंद्रा अक्यूजिंग हर ऑफ बीइंग करप्ट एज ऑफ नाउ देर आर कंप्लेंट्स अगेंस्ट मदाबी फ्रॉम ऑल फोर साइड्स इंटरनेशनल डोमेस्टिक इंटरनल एज वेल एज पॉलिटिकल लेट्स टेक अ लुक एट ऑल फोर मेजर एलिगेशंस एलिगेशन नंबर वन बाय हिंडनबर्ग रिसर्च Back in March, Booch had called herself Unilever wife at a public forum while explaining how she is working on making the sachetization of mutual funds with 250 rupees SIP viable. Her husband, Dhaval Booch, worked in HUL and Unilever globally for 35 years before joining Blackstone. Hindenburg spotted a connection and alleged that during Dhaval Booch's time as an advisor to Blackstone, SEBI proposed, approved and facilitated major REIT regulations and changes. This includes 7 consultation papers, 3 consolidated updates, 2 new regulatory frameworks and nomination rights for units, which in turn benefited private equity firms like Blackstone. Another major allegation against the Boochs is that they invested in offshore funds linked to the Adanis. All parties have denied the charges. Number 2 allegations by Congress. Congress spokesperson Pawan Khera recently claimed that Booch continued to receive a salary from ICICI Bank while she was working with SEBI. With this, he raised concerns of a serious breach of ethics and accountability in public service. Although ICICI Bank has clarified that she only received retirement benefits after her superannuation in October 2023. Number 3. Subhash Chandra's allegations. Zee Group founder Subhash Chandra accused Booch of corruption, blaming her for obstructing the Zee-Sony merger. SEBI has barred Chandra and his son Puneet Goenka from holding key positions in any listed firms until further orders on fund diversion charges. Lastly, number 4, employee complaints. SEBI employees have accused Booch of fostering a toxic work environment, citing incidents of shouting, scolding, and public humiliation in meetings. They have reported these issues to the Finance Ministry, alleging the use of unprofessional language by higher management. Well, that is all for today. Stay tuned to ET Markets for more.